design guidelines play a key role at early stage of building design to take into consideration the main climate responsive strategies for sustainable buildings. In this lesson, we will provide designers with a set of guidelines for sustainable buildings according to different EAC climatic zones. The main topics covered are design strategies for site planning, considering especially sun protection and ventilation, and design strategies for building plan, considering sun protection, ventilation, structures, as roof, wall and ceilings, and windows or ventilation openings. Zone 1. Hot, humid. Main climatic features are never excessively hot, permanent high humidity, generally high temperatures, small daily temperature swings, moderate wind breezes, high solar radiation values. In order to provide sun protection, the building should be surrounded by trees, shrubs and grass, which will absorb solar radiation, not reflecting it into the building. Trees need to be with high trunk and appropriately positioned to avoid screening of the wind. Natural ventilation should be exploited as far as possible, so sites exposed to prevailing breezes are highly desirable. The closer the sea and the higher the ground, the more the breeze. Local orography may change the northeast-southwest monsoon's direction. When monsoons are not blowing, it is important to exploit the local breezes. These winds are useful from 1 to 8 km inland, depending on the terrain, and their direction is generally perpendicular to the coastline. Sites surrounded by hills or screened from the prevailing winds by hills or thick forests should be avoided. Ventilation conditions in well-spaced, high-rise or multi-story dwellings are likely to be better than in single-story houses. Therefore, at high urban densities, an increase in height is generally preferable. In the building plan, it is of primary importance to ensure suitable sun protection. For this reason, windows should be provided with shading devices. Furthermore, building should be preferably be orientated with a long axis running east-west to provide easy, effective shading and minimize east and west facing openings in order to reduce early morning and late afternoon heat gain. Also, natural ventilation should be properly addressed, since after sun shading it is the most important element affecting comfort. Buildings should allow maximum ventilation, taking advantage from their shape, orientation and layout. Cross ventilation, in this sense, represents a very effective solution, taking into account that there is more wind in higher stories. If possible, buildings should be more than one story high, preferably with the ground floor left open or used for non-living purposes. And now some suggestions regarding specific building elements. For example, regarding the roof, it has to be said that an important feature is to protect walls, openings and interior from direct sunlight, particularly on east and west walls. Whatever type of roof is used, it should have generous overhangs not less than 0.6 meters and preferably about 1 meter. The roof should be made of lightweight materials with low thermal capacity and high reflectivity, and should be ventilated or well insulated to reduce the heat gain due to solar radiation. If the roof is not insulated, a ceiling is needed, and the space between roof and ceiling should be ventilated for reducing thermal discomfort. It is even better if the ceiling is also insulated. The walls should have a low thermal capacity. Sun protection is very important and can be achieved by orienting east-west the long axis of the building, shading with overhangs, verandas or other devices, shading with trees. Cavity or hollow bricks walls should be used for non-shaded elevations. Finally, in order to allow maximum air movement, large windows and ventilation openings are required, preferably located on north and south facades and equipped with shading devices. Zone 2. Hot, arid. In this zone, maximum temperatures are higher than those of the hot, humid climate, and high is also the daily temperature variation. Humidity, especially in the hottest hours, is very low. Housing layouts should be in compact urban form. Compact planning minimizes the solar exposure of individual houses and reduces solar heat gains by providing mutual shading and by reducing external surface areas. Buildings should preferably be located on elevation ground, where the breezes offer more relief by night. Buildings should be compact, but allowing good natural night ventilation, and should be oriented with the long axis running where possible, east-west to provide effective shading. Heavyweight building envelope is recommended because of high daily temperature swing. In order to keep building interiors as cool as possible during daytime, it is important that solar exposure of facades is reduced to a minimum. Courtyard houses are traditionally well established because they are compact and give sufficient ventilation. Regarding the building elements, note that roofs should be preferably made of heavyweight materials and high reflectivity coatings and should be ventilated. Alternatively, if the roof is lightweight, the ceiling should be heavyweight and the attic ventilated. Heavyweight walls are climatically well suited for this zone. Walls having a time lag of 11-12 hours are excellent for their rooms, provided that they are adequately ventilated at night. Mud block, brick or soil cement walls should not be less than 30 cm, the thicker the better. Walls should also be light colored, and in order to improve comfort during night, bedroom walls should be lightweight. For windows and ventilation openings, solar protection is of course recommended. A good solution consists in the use of shading systems that also allow natural ventilation. In this regard, it should be noted that adequate night ventilation helps to prevent overheating. An effective mitigation strategy in this climate is represented by evaporative cooling because of the low values of relative humidity during daytime. So, simple direct evaporative cooling devices can be used during hottest hours if water is available. Zone 3. Hot semi-arid savanna. The difference from the hot arid zone is represented by relatively higher humidity values but lower peak temperatures and daily temperature swings. The design strategies for this zone are similar to the hot arid zone except the envelope, which should be mid-weight because of the lower daily temperature swings in hot semi-arid parts and heavyweight in savanna plains due to the lower night temperature. In this climate, evaporative cooling is not as effective because of the higher values of relative humidity. Zone 4. Great Lakes. In the Great Lakes area, the temperature is slightly lower than in the savanna zones, but daily variations are comparable. On the contrary, humidity is higher than in savanna zone, even if in the same altitude range, just due to the lakes. Site selection criteria are similar to that related to the hot humid coastal zone. Early afternoon breezes from the lakes and evening breezes from the land are due to the difference of temperature between water and land. This means that the prevailing winds are perpendicular to the coast. A compromise orientation of the building may be necessary between the long axis running east-west to provide effective shading and the direction of the winds blowing perpendicular to the coast. As regards building elements, mid-weight walls are recommended to smooth indoors temperature because night temperature is often below the comfort range. External walls should preferably be light colored. Zone 5. Upland. The main climatic characteristics are pretty low temperatures, fairly high humidity similar to that of hot humid zone, moderate breezes with no predominant direction. Generally, in the upland, building sites should be so selected as to provide shelter against prevailing winds and cold air pockets in ground depressions. Buildings should have their main glazed elevations oriented north-south. Also, northeast-southwest orientation with most of the room facing northeast is appropriate. With carefully calculated sun shading, this orientation will allow a certain amount of solar heat to penetrate during the cold season in the early morning and cut off low west sun in the afternoon. Roofs can be light or heavy, but they must have a good insulation value. Medium-weight walls, floors and ceilings are recommended for the best exploitation of solar passive gains. Regarding windows and ventilation openings, devices for sun control are necessary in order to keep out the sun during certain hours of the day. Note that they should be also adjustable to let sun in when it is required. Windows should be placed mainly on north and south elevation for an easier sun control. In this sense, adjustable louvers outside and curtains or preferably Venetian blind inside the room will be the best method of solar control. Large windows facing east or west should be avoided due to the risk of overheating for greenhouse effect and the related need to ventilate using the excessively cold air from outside. All windows should be glazed and windows frames should be reasonably airtight. Unlike other zones, here flexible heating systems should be provided to ensure comfortable indoor temperatures. Zone 6, high upland. In this zone, the same provisions of zone 5 should be made, with more attention paid to the need for heating due to the lower temperatures all along the year. In general, exposed sites should be avoided, particularly along the forested ridges where strong winds and driving rain may be experienced. The exposed nature of many sites in this zone makes it necessary to group houses in order to give protection and shelter against cold winds. Spacing of houses should be kept to be the minimum compatible with the need to exploit solar radiation. Regarding the building plan, it has to be said that the major climatic performance criterion for houses is to provide protection from the cold. The design strategies for this zone are similar to those of the Zone 5, with increased emphasis on passive solar design. If coupled with proper solar control when needed, greenhouse effect due to glazed openings could be efficiently exploited.